I finally went on this blind date for my friend Jeanette from Meta Meditation. And she's got this guy in her chanting club, and she's always trying to get me to see him. She says she thinks I'm lonely, which means that her husband is lonely. And she said, he's in PR. Now, I'm interested. I want to see what this looks like. This will be fun. So we exchange a few emails, and he says, let's meet at the Grove. I like the Grove. I see him at the valet. He's not holding a ticket in his hand. First red flag. You could be parked on the third floor in a Jetta. We walk to the restaurant. See, I'm not saying anything. I'm just observing. And he's complimenting me. Oh, you're a model. You're beautiful. You should be a model. And this constant thing that I always get. And he's wearing a gold Rolex watch. So overall, I mean, my first impressions. He's Armenian. Armenian families, they're pretty wealthy. They do all right for themselves. He takes me past the bar. He doesn't stop. And I'm thinking, oh, a little cheap. It felt like saying, listen, I intend to pay for my share. I don't care what you get, but I'm buying my own food. But no, I thought, I'm going to have some fun. See what you're made of. So I watched his face while I was looking at the most expensive items on the menu. And I ordered a $42 hamburger. He seemed intimidated by me. I kept the conversation light at that point. I'd already decided not to date him. He was so needy. If he can't handle me being a supermodel, what's he gonna do when I start talking about my career and my multinational entrepreneurial company, the fact that I speak three languages, English, French, and Spanish? And then he said that he was glad we weren't talking about work because he wasn't one of those people who needed to prove himself with every conversation. And I thought, oh, I'm proud of what I've done and I don't need to prove myself to anybody. So I said, aha, okay then, if you're in PR, how many of your clients are on the Forbes Rich List? And how many of your clients have a mention in this month's Marie Claire magazine? And to that, he pretended to laugh like it didn't matter and shrugged it off. He said, oh, I don't know, maybe one or two. But he said it loud enough so that I could hear. And I said, that is a trick question because the Forbes Rich List is an old, outdated list. It's for dinosaurs. Nobody uses that list. Well, I didn't say that, but I thought it. No, not for me. I left him at the side of the road waiting for his imaginary car. Well, I got in my cab. Anyway, the bus turned up before the cab, so I just hopped on the bus. That's how I roll. I'm a free spirit. I'm independent, and I dig all forms of people in life, even the poor ones on the bus.